Good morning, Tehmina Khan is here in TK Maths is fun. In this video, I will explain to you the sketch of sine cos tangent, which is a part of the trigonometric syllabus of additional mathematics O level. I have taken one or two examples to explain here these sketches. For detailed explanation and more examples, you can refer the link given in the description in which I have made separate video on each one of them on sine, cosine and tangent. But this video contains all the three sketches because some people needed quick recap, so they requested for such type of video, right? So let's begin with this. And by the way, this is my blog address and website address. You can see there are many useful links available, videos available, and many other information related to O and A level syllabus. You can refer it. Thank you. So let's see here. We start with sine sketch, right? The sketch of sine y is equals to sine x. Now if you see the y is equals to sine s sketch, you will get this type of curve. Now which points you will plot? Will you point each and every point of 0 to 360? No, you will only plot sine 0, which will give you 0 answer. You can use your calculator right now while I'm speaking. Sine 90, if you plug in sine 90 in your calculator, you will get 1. Sine 180, 0. Sine 270, minus 1. Sine 361. So whenever you are sketching sine or cosine graph, you have to take four key points, one, two, three, four, five. And after that, you will just give it a shape of wave, right? Sine and cos are very similar. So I'm explaining sine in very much detail. So pay attention, because cos may, it will be exactly same. The shape will be a little different, you will see. Now, this is a general sine graph. So everybody remembers it like this. Okay, so 0 answer is at 0 degree, 180 degree, 360 degree. Because we have to remember key points. 90 degree, we get maximum point. At 270, we get minimum point. The point here is, if I look at this equation, trigonometric equation, I have here 1, I have here 1, and I have nothing here. It's 0. Then this curve is fine. What if I have a number here? 2, 3, 4, minus 5, minus 6, it could be plus and minus. What if I have a number here? What if I have a number here? So rather than learning for each one differently, let's see how do we handle these type of equations, right? Once you know the connection between them, automatically you can handle all type of equations in sine. Right, so this is your general equation of sine. This is the basic for basic understanding, and for 0 to 360 to show you that cycle period of sine completes in 360. If you continue after this, the shape of the curve will be like this. It will keep repeating the wave. So this is called a cycle period. I mean one type of shape. After that, it will repeat itself. Right, so now let's see the connection here. So I have taken this example here, and in this example, before I tell you any connection, look at the graph and try to figure out what connection or what sense it makes to you. If I see here, my highest point is 4 here. So how can you get 4 from here? My lowest point is minus 2. It's minus 2. What is the impact of this 2 on the graph? My cycle period is completing in 0 to 180 here. So let's see here. I told you the general form is y is equals to a sine bx plus c. Same will be the case with cos. This number here gives you the amplitude. Okay, what does it give you? Amplitude. Amplitude means how high or low the wave will be from the line which is drawn at this number. Right? If you say this is y equals to one line, yes or no? And it is called axis of the curve or the principal axis. So this number has a connection with this. This tells you how high you have to go from here. So 1 plus 3 is 4. That's why it is at 4. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. So we learn one thing from here, that c plus a will give us maximum, and C minus A will give us minimum. So at least we figured out are maximum value and minimum value. Now, what is the role of this B? We have seen that cycle period of sine, original one, completes in 0 to 360. Whatever the number will be here, it will tell you how many cycles you will have in 360. It is written 2 here. So if I'm completing my cycles, this is called a cycle. If I complete my complete cycle in 2 cycles in 360, it means 360 divided by 2 will tell me how many degrees I will take to complete one cycle. So that's why it is written here 120. And question is saying draw for x 0 to 180. So question is giving you the question is giving you that you have to sketch only for 0 to 180. And other thing we learned that for each sketch we need how many intervals? 1, 2, 3, 4. We have to divide it into 4 intervals. So that's why 180 is divided into 4 intervals. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So after that, we have equally divided them. 180 ka half is 90, and half of 90 is 45. And half of 90 and 180 is 135. This is how we have marked these angles on the axis of the curve. 0, 90, 180. Because axis of the curve has degrees in the alternate order. Can you notice? Here, 0, then maximum. 0, then minimum. 0, then maximum. Then 0. So it is an alternate order. So that's why I will mark at 0 degree, at 90 degree, at 180 degree. And maximum will be at 45 in this case, because we know from here basic thing, after 0 it is maximum, then axis, then minimum. So that is how we are marking at maximum point and minimum point and completing the shape. So what we have learned from here, let me just erase it here and increase the size what I have written here for you. Give me a second here. I jotted down this point for you basically. That your maximum value in this curve is C plus A. So it is this plus this. This is your C and this is your A. So C plus A gives you maximum value and C minus A minimum value. Right? And C, the number which is here itself is the axis of the curve, the straight line, horizontal line, above and below which the curve will have this height. And B is your cycle period. So your cycle period for this curve is 180 degree because there are 2 cycles in 360. Now, what I have drawn here, just to show you that the same graph, if it was drawn for 0 to 360 degree, then from 0 degree to 360 degree, you have 2 cycles. One completed at 180, other at 360. So I hope it makes sense to you. Same sine graph, if it is in the modulus, then whatever the part of the curve is coming below the x-axis. Now please pay attention. Below the x-axis. I'm not saying below the axis of the curve. I'm saying the part of the curve which is coming below the x-axis, because below the x-axis, the values of y are negative. That curve we will reflect in the x-axis. So when it is modulus, first step is forget the modulus and sketch the graph the way you do and then reflect it. For example, if I have 2 sine x plus 1, for example, right, the previous curve, suppose this one, if it was in the modulus, let me erase the rest of the thing, then it will make more sense to you. So if I have this equation in the modulus, then the part which is below the x-axis, I would reflect it in the x-axis. Now this is the part below the x-axis. Can you notice this part? So from here till here, and this is minus 2. So suppose minus 2 is here. Suppose mark a point here and draw this line. So your curve will be final curve for this sketch, because they have drawn extra line here. You don't need to. You always do very precise from here till here, from here till here. That's all. Right? So you have to draw it for the above the x-axis. Make sense? Okay. So now come to cos graph. the cost graph, I have written this as it is because I told you it is all same. By the way, if you have here minus y is equals to minus sine x, what comes in your mind? What will happen to this graph? Can you think? It will be reflected in the x-axis, the whole graph, because whatever the value is plus will become minus. So if you have y is equals to minus sine x, then this curve will be like this. Okay, the curve gets upside down. Remember it, either it is cos graph, sine graph, tan graph, they all are reflected in the x-axis. I have discussed all this in detail in my videos, which are in the link given below in the description. Okay, so now come to cos x. This is a general cos graph. In cos graph, again, you need 5 points maximum, the point on the axis of the curve, minimum, the point on the axis of the curve, and maximum. So here again, cycle period is 0 to 360, right? So now on the axis of the curve, now you have 90 and 270. So on the axis of the curve, you will mark 0 at 90 degree and 270 degree. In the sine graph, you were marking it at 0, 180 and 360, right? So maximum point is at 0 degree and 360 degree and minimum is at 180 degree. You have to remember this, right? So let's draw this graph separately before looking at it. 3 cos 2x minus 1. Let's do it here. 3 cos 2x minus 1. This is my axis of the curve, like I have told you, right? Sorry. Suppose this is minus 1. Okay. So this is my x-axis. This is my y-axis. I have plus sign here. So minus 1 plus 3 will give me maximum. Minus 1 minus 3 will give me minimum. The logic is same, which we have done it in what? Sine graph. Now, I have to divide it into 4. By the way, it is 2x. It means between 0 to 360, I will have 2 cycles. So let me complete 2 cycles between 0 to 360. Suppose this is 360. This is 180. Okay. So I will have one complete cycle here and one complete cycle here. Now, the shape of the cos graph is like this. This is your 0. This is minus 1. Oh, this is, let me take a scale closer because there is not much space otherwise. Minus 1 is here. Okay. So, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. 0, 1, 2. So, from the axis of the curve, 3 units up. And from the axis of the curve, 1, 2, 3 units down. Okay. Now, I'm dividing 180 degree into 4 parts. And on the axis of the curve, I'm dividing it. Minus 1 is my axis of the curve. Here also, I'm dividing it into 4 parts. Now, the curve graph, cos graph, start with maximum point. Then next degree is axis of the curve. Then next degree, because these are degrees, right? This is 180, this is 90. You can write the half of it yourself here. 135, this will be 270, and so on. So anyway, so you will mark on the 0 degree maximum point, then the point on the axis of the curve, then at 90 degree minimum, then next degree axis of the curve, then 180, you will mark maximum again, then next degree axis of the curve, next degree is minimum, next degree axis of the curve, next degree is maximum. So this is how you will plot it. Now join all the points. Now this looks a little pointed. It should not, because it is not easy to write with the board. Anyway, so this is the curve I have, right? And this is exactly the curve which is drawn here. So I hope you understood sine and cos. And again, if it is in modulus, the part which is below the x-axis, you will reflect in the x-axis. Okay, now come to 10. Okay, this question also left. Sorry, I picked up this question also. So cos graph 2 cos x plus 1 for 0 to 2 pi. Okay, I'm leaving it for the time being because it is in radian and I have not explained radian here. So just leave this curve and let's come to 10. Y is equals to 10x. First of all, look at this graph. If you have a calculator and you put 1090, it will give you error. Then put 270, it will again give you error. But if you put 1089.999, you will get a very big positive value. And 10, 0, 0. So 10 graph basically takes this shape. Cycle period of 10 is 0 to 180 degree. That's all. It completes its cycle is 180. After that, it repeats itself. Now, if I want to continue, it will be like this. Same shape, like it is here. See, going up from 180 going down. One cycle complete, from here going up, from here going down. Next, if you will draw, going up and then going down with the same interval. So this is the 10 graph thing. There is no maximum or minimum in 10 graph, remember it. And the line towards which the curve is approaching but never touches is called asymptote. So if we see the general form of 10 graph, same thing like we did in sine and cos, a tan bx plus c, there is no maximum minimum. You can't do C plus A is maximum, C minus A is minimum. No, there is no maximum minimum. This is your axis of the curve. This number here just give you how steep the curve will become. Within this interval, maybe it gets steeper and steeper, or it gets like this. So this shape of the curve here is identified because of this number. There's another use of it, but I'm not going into detail of this. That is not required basically as such. So with this, I think I will finish this question. Plus 1 is my axis of the curve. 10 graph has axis of the curve at 0 degree and 180 degree. So it is here and here. And then it will go up from here and it will go down from here and that's all. It will not touch it, right? So this is your tan sketch. And let's see. If there is 2x, 3x something which affects the cycle period. The example I took here has no 2x, right? So now it has 2x. It means because the cycle period completes in 180 degree, right? So within 360, how many cycles you will have? For simple one, I'm talking about 10x. If you have 2x here, it means within 180, you will have two cycles. So within 360, how many cycles you will have? Four cycles, right? If I had simple 10x, then within 180, one cycle, within 360, two cycle. But right now it is 10 2x, and the cycle period of 10 is 0 to 180 degree. So within 180, I will have two cycles and another 360 till 360, two. So there will be four cycles, you can see here. So each cycle will be completed in 90 degree and you will keep making interval with 45 degree addition and that's all. So thank you very much for watching this video. Like I said, if you want to see more examples, more explanation, you can click the link given in the description below. And I have prepared trigonometrics guidelines or notes also for you. So please do refer it. I hope it would help you. Thank you very much for watching this video. Next video is on reciprocal functions of trigonometry and identities. So take care. Allah Hafiz. Do like and share this video, please.